at the base of all that we face as a nation is the question of identity. The question of identity draws also, Christy made a fantastic presentation, but we need to really agree among ourselves, who are we? Because who we have will determine the kind of leadership we have, will determine the kind of ideas that will appeal to us. It will determine the way we are seen by the world. Who are we? We must ask ourselves. The most famous, most influential man that ever walked the face of the earth was asked the question, who do people say I am? So the question again is, who are we? Who are we as a people? Who are we as individuals? Who are we as a nation? How do we want to be seen? How are we seen? What is the best approach to us being seen the way we want to be seen? Until all of those questions are answered, it is difficult to really call ourselves a nation that has a focus. Well, there are different dimensions to the question of identity. In the field in which I practice, we like to talk about publics, we talk about internal publics and external publics. So, we talk about the nation Nigeria. In the world we live in today, nations are brands. There's a definite, decisive effort made to position a country the way it wants to be seen in the world. Otherwise, somebody else will define you. There's no standards. That's why today, Nigeria is seen through many lenses. Some see. When Nigeria comes forth, what it starts in the mind of the people. Don't forget that man by nature is such that see things through pictures. So when I say car, you're not seeing see her, they're just going to see a picture. So when Nigeria comes forth, what is the thing that comes to the mind of the recipient? What kind of country comes to mind? Is it 419? Is it a country of happy people? Is it a country of proud, brash people? You know, the main thing has something to do with xenophobia. And we all know what played out in South Africa of recent. Nigerians are definitely not very happy with the way South Africans have reacted to Nigerians over the years. Nigerians believe we've done a whole lot to get apartheid out of South Africa. Yes, South Africans are reacting to us in a particular way. The question is, are we seen the way we want to be seen? A few years back, I was in Germany, I was in the South African embassy, and the South African embassy in Berlin, and South African ambassador made a presentation to us about how their own country interfaces with the world. Their trade, the volume of trade and all of that. And I looked at it, the volume of trade, I looked at what South Africa was doing. I noticed that South Africa had most of its oil was coming from Saudi Arabia. And I asked the question, I asked the ambassador to South Africa, I said, how come your country is buying so much oil from South Africa, from Saudi Arabia? Nigeria is there, Angola is there. The man was, he was tongue-tied. And that's it. And that's it. Nigeria likes to price itself as a giant of Africa. Why are we the giant of Africa? Should we even be the giant of Africa? What does it mean to be a giant of Africa? Who really wants a giant as a neighbor? Nigeria is wholly surrounded by France. All around us, Nigeria is surrounded by France. We are not surrounded by Benin Republic, Chad, and Nigeria, all of those. We are surrounded by France. So we need to properly identify who we are and identify who we have around us so that we can properly identify us. So when you throw your ways around and you say you're the giants of Africa, people, they are like looking at you. Why would ECOWAS not work? There are Francophone, there's a Francophone tendency within that group. There are people being telegraphed from other parts of the world. Those are the issues that we have to bring into focus before we design. Nigeria presently opposes its foreign policy based on what it calls the concentric circles. You know, the immediate Labour Conference, then it goes to Africa, then to the world. But have we defined our national interest? Who are we? Have we formed ourselves internally? Who is a Nigerian? First and foremost. What makes you a Nigerian? Is it where you were born? Is it where you reside? Have a little boy. His grandfather spent most of his life in the part of Nigeria where he doesn't really come from. That's where it's, he has rights. What do you think he has rights to? I'm his father. I come from another state in Nigeria. His mother comes from another state, another ethnic group in Nigeria. Now, his parents reside in a particular place. Who reside in it? So, where does he come from? And is he from Edo state? Where is his mom hails from? By what Nigerians define as, and chosen to define where the person hails from. Is he from Ondo? Where he has never been? Where I'm supposed to come from? Is he from Lagos? Where I lived the larger chunk of my life before moving to Lagos? Or is he from Lagos, where he was born, where he has lived all his life? We have not resolved the question of identity even within us. So yes, we want the world to respect us. We want to be the envy of the world, as my friend has seen. Think we should aspire to. Nothing wrong with that, but you must realize that every product you see out there, every that bottle of water that sits there, is a thought. There's a thought behind it. It's deliberately positioned to achieve a certain objective. And unless we see our nation in that regard, unless we realize that building up a nation would require such an effort, then we are not even starting. Unless we realize that we have to deliberately build up Nigerians to believe in whatever we have designed that country to be, then we have not started. Every nation of North that has made it in this world has been propelled by a body of values and ideas that govern, that galvanize it towards a clear direction. We are not going to be any different. And the unfortunate thing is, if you don't do it deliberately, what else will do it for you? They will define you. They will call you by whatever name. They call you a 419 country. They will call you by whatever. Why is it that when we have the privilege to make presentations outside of Nigeria, you speak and people are like, oh, really? Oh, you're from Nigeria. You are from Nigeria. They're Nigerian. They're shocked because they already have an expectation of who you're supposed to be. They've already boxed you. They believe you're supposed to be a particular group. So they now try to take you out of that box and say, okay, you are the. They are the different one. Which Nigerian do they really know of? Which Nigerian are we presenting to the world? Well, this is the same Nigeria of Elabuzi. It's the same Nigeria of Kabaka. It's the same Nigeria of Walishenga. So which Nigeria are we pushing to the world? Is it the Nigeria of a man who has been a drug fugitive for 7 years old, now is just exactly the face of the world? So what are we? There are many countries in the world. You take time, talk about Germany. Germany is known for number of citizens. You see it, you're all also, you know, they are trying to do those interesting works. Things work. Precision is what that country is known for. I hope I'm right. There are countries that are known for football. So we have to make up our mind, what do we want to be known for? And we have to start internally. We have to make up our mind, what who we have as a people. What are the values that guide us? Sometimes people ask, why are we like that? Jump, use, do all of that. Are we, is that who we really are? I would like to believe that the bulk of Nigerians are hard good people. Maybe that's what people go to the government and the police and to say, good Nigerians or happy Nigerians, or something like that. That's it. Happy. Maybe something like that. But I think me hearing enough is that. Ability to empathize. That's what we take with our minds. And I will listen to Kamaka, I will listen to Petra, and forget what we want them. That's the Nigerian one. The Nigerian will leave his business ordinarily to assist you. The hospitality thing is inherent in every Nigerian. But look at what has happened to us in the last few months, that of elections. Some people ran a very divisive campaign that we could not even recognize ourselves anymore. And you will see post-election. People are still bitter. People are trying to rationalize the rejection. They can't, I mean, is that the Nigeria want to protect the world? So, I mean, you cannot earn respect outside if you have not worked for it internally. As it said, you know, the Air Force is not in our stars, it's in our brand. Some of these things are very easy to do. When your leader travels abroad and he rejects your Rolls Royce and says, no, I'm here on the private side, I choose to do this particular, send a message down the line. So we need to come to a decisive moment in our life and decide this is the direction we want to go. Forge an identity for ourselves. So all this internal, forget about, I mean, we need to forget about all this craziness that I turned all around. Some of us had the privilege of going to, I'm a product of the Faragam College. I went to, into secondary school at the age of 10. I related with people from different parts of Nigeria. So how can I begin? Where do I even start from? Where do I start from? I mean, I had friends from all over Nigeria, from Nigeria, from everywhere. We related together. We didn't know the difference between the Yoruba man and Hausa man. What can we do even thinking in that direction? That's not who we are. Nigerians are hospitable by nature, inherently. So it's important that we key into that. You know, we talk about unity in diversity. Of course, you can make of whatever you are faced with, whatever you want, whatever you want from it. We are diverse. Is it a strength? Is it a weakness? Your job, because I see Nigeria as a product that we should work on to become, so that it can become a brand. The way it works in the industry in which I practice is that you look at the product, you identify what are the strengths, what are the weaknesses, opportunities, SWOT, you do your SWOT analysis. Okay. What is most unique about it? You identify its unique selling proposition. Every nation has its own challenges, you know that. Nigeria has lots and lots of challenges. That should not define us. It should never define us. Our responsibility. So come together as a people, identify our strengths, play on our strengths, pull that together. Do away all of those things that pull us apart. There's absolutely no reason. In fact, the fact that we have a whole lot of problems and challenges facing us should, as a matter of fact, pull us together. We should reason together, think along it. And of course, leadership is important because leadership is influential. It's only then that we can begin to talk about how do we interface with it. How are we going to present ourselves? We have to make a deliberate attempt to take custody of, take ownership of our story. What narrative are we pushing to the world? Who are brand ambassadors? Who is the face of Nigeria? We have, you know, our soft power quotient. It's huge. Massive. Because the world we live in today, you know, the days of playing hard power, even America and other parts of other countries of the world, they realize soft power or the mix of the smart power is what you need right now. You work with the intangibles. I mean, your writers are there, your actors are there, your assistants are there, your footballers are there, the canoe workers are there. Push these places forward. Let them be the face of Nigeria. Do your own work. Galvanize people towards a particular objective and a direction. Give us direction and let us move clearly towards that direction. And that is it. That's how nations are built. Nations are deliberate constructs. They are not accidental. A country can be accidental, like Nigeria. Some of us, they tell us a mere geographical expression. But we need to move away from that. We need to move quickly away from, and we don't have time. So people laugh at when you say that you don't need to be, who wants to be enabled to be giants? You don't need that. Let whatever you do, let it speak for that. That's why passes do it. We are struggling. AFP elections are holding, and I think there are about 4 candidates from the summit. How are you going to achieve the anticipating energy? Look at Boko Haram and all of the issues that we will get a lot of oppression from, because you have lost respect. And you cannot force people to respect you. You cannot force people to respect you. Nigerians are treated the way they are because of the way we have positioned ourselves in the minds of people. So the responsibility is ours. We have to realize that we have internal public and we have external public. Ensure that your internal public key into what you stand for so that they can build your ambassadors and market you to the world. Thank you. God bless.